Good morning, and welcome to not only Barbados, but to the second anniversary of the EMC Gatherings. That would be all of you all. Congratulations to each and every one of our members, and welcome to beautiful Barbados. 21st of January being celebrated today, the Honourable Errol Walton Barrow, his birthday. He was the father of independence, and so happens that we've also celebrated our second anniversary, and this is our date to remember the beginning. And we will not have an ending date, because this will continue forever beyond myself and everyone that's here. More to each and every one of you all. You've been seeing some beautiful views here of Carlisle Bay area. We want to say our serenity prayer with you. Those who'd like to join us, please do. Remember, this is a prayer for peace and calmness, stability, guidance, and understanding. If you don't understand the prayer, I ask you to say it a few times and really understand what you're responsible for. And that will be for one thing only, and that's yourself. You can only be responsible for your actions, the way you respond, the way you love, the way you care, the way you forgive. Everything else is in responsibility for me, for God, and for you, for your higher power, or for your brighter light, or whoever you follow. As long as it's positive, we really don't care. Positivity is all we're interested in. So we'll say our serenity prayer now. Those who would like to join us, please do so. All others, we'll be back in a few moments' time. God, grant us the serenity to accept the things we cannot change, the courage to change the things that we can, and the wisdom to know the difference. Your will, not ours, be done. Amen. Good morning to each and every one of you all. As you can see, we have quite a few people with us this morning. Our host this morning, as usual, will be Nicole, but she's giving me a little bit of time. I actually had to take the gimbal, my gimbal, from her because she did not really want to give it to me this morning, so I didn't even put it in her hands. Anyhow, I'm going to turn you over to Nicole. Have a great day. Love you all. Thanks for being here to celebrate this amazing occasion with all of us. Thank you.
Good morning, EMC. Happy anniversary. It is a pleasure to be here with you this morning, and I hope you enjoy this docile walk with us. It promised to be fun, laughter, and so much more. So let us get started with this beautiful scenery that we have been seeing all morning. And that would not be me. So, oh, isn't that just magnificent? Louis Armstrong said it, what a wonderful world. And it has been a wonderful world for all of us who have joined the EMC in these last 2 years. The amazing news and beauty of Browns Beach as morning wakes up, as we take a quiet stroll hopefully share some historic facts with you, laughter along the way, and tons of love as well. The one thing about us this morning is going to be tons of fun, tons of characters on the beach, tons of things happening. So first of all, let me introduce you guys to everybody who is present with us this morning.
Well, I'm Nick. Hi, how are you going? I don't need an introduction.
Good morning, Mary.
Good morning.
Switch Mary. And I hope Ray comes on this morning because we got a little happy and took his Spice Girls to a different level. So we are in our Spice shirts for our anniversary. So Mary,
switch
Mary. And the girls are all in their EMC church, just the shirts this morning. Thank you, Mary. And I'm going to ask our head cheerleader to put down her phone for 2 seconds. Stop sulking and show us the front of her shirt. The front, that's the back. The front, she is Chic Spice. Yes. And look, our Westie. Yes?
Number one.
The future Mrs.
Dean.
I'll help you there. Thank you. So she is Westie Spice. This is, Jackie can introduce herself.
Good morning, everyone.
She's Party Spice. And, okay, I need to get my bag holder. My telephone holder. I keep the rest. Yeah.
I'll put it in my pocket.
She showed
her. And I am Care Spice. I think my words will be reversed, but you get the gist. I'm Care Spice. So
the Gimbal Stealer.
Welcome to the Spice Girls. Nicholas Dean.
I can't get it turned. Can you turn this off or something?
Yes, I did.
Okay.
You know how it goes.
I'll hide my eyes on.
6, 7,
hold on a second, folks, as we do our
25.
Our technical moments. So, enough laughter and smiles from me for today.
Liar.
Liar.
And here we have our land shark, Dimitri. Please say good morning to the
morning.
Folks.
Dimitri, try to everybody.
And we have been blessed to have again the lovely Caroline with us. Yes. And we have Ryan. Ryan was here with us last year on our first anniversary. And Ryan is here again. So it's not too late to come down and join us this morning as we take a walk down the beach. Well, now that I've gotten rid of my bag, I can move. So everybody else will follow. And we're going to touch a bit of Bay Street, and I think it's important as we start this new year, we're a little way in, we're coming to the end of January, that you know our health and wellness is primary importance. Here in Barbados this week, they talked about the amount of school children who have had challenges through this COVID epidemic and the psychological challenges that have been. So it's really important for us to remember that our health and wellness is so important, that we need to take care of each other and look out for each other. So I'm going to start where you should always start, by thanking God for inspiring Nicholas to take this journey and to trust him and to open up his heart and let so many of us in. And because he did that, here we are on the second anniversary. Here I am holding his gimbal. Who would have thought? But, you know, it's all part of the journey. And I'm sure that everybody here will get a chance to come home, be a part of this experience, and not just get the virtual hugs, but the live hugs as well. And so on Browns Beach today, there are numerous companies setting up their beach chairs and umbrellas so that they can provide some fun today on this Arabaro Day. I know that in our botanical gardens here, the government is having a massive picnic and artists coming out to perform and to give some comfort and enjoyment to everybody on this Saturday. And usually in Barbados on a Saturday, everything is open and bustling. But because It's a national holiday. Businesses that normally would have been open are closed today. You will find that the fast food restaurants and restaurant areas will be open because, you know, I encourage people out. There'll be a lot of picnicking going on. So if you get in a car and drive around the island today, you'll see all the major picnic spots. People are picnicking. And it is just a way of relaxing your mind, heart, and soul, and thanking the Father of Independence for all that he did to uplift the country and move us forward in a period of time so that we had free education, free school meals, the infrastructure, people who could not access banking loans. He did that, put things in place for that. And it is just our way of saying a major thank you to a man with a vision of Barbados. And I hope that we continue to live the way we do, that things that are Barbadian, we don't try to take apart as we continue to grow, that our youth and young people are, you know, to be taught what being Bajan and what is being Barbadian is all about. So here we are at the beautiful, beautiful Browns Beach. And I think I need Nicholas because I need to find the path that he was telling me about. Nick, you're going to show me where this path is? To get on, to get onto up that area.
Well, we can walk right down the bridge and come up. I'm only kidding.
I think. Oh, I see where those people are coming through there.
Yeah. That's one of them.
Oh, okay. And that's interesting that this is where the lifeguard hut, because there used to be a jetty here many years ago, and this beach did not exist. This would have been deep water at that point in time. So when they did the fisheries complex shifted the whole area, and this is how part of this big beach was developed. Because years ago, even by in front of the government headquarters and the bandstand is, all of that would have been water. The water used to just hit the rocks there. So this massive, massive beach that we are on now that forms part of this beautiful vista that everyone tends to walk did not exist 20, 25 years ago, or even longer. It just did not exist. So there was a big long beach, a pier here, just like the pier in the distance. There was a pier right along here where this lifeguard hut is. And this pier used to be where it was deep, deep, deep water. So none of all this big massive sand built up, and this, and you know, the chairs and all that could be out of, none of that was here. So all of this is relatively new. And one of the things that I noticed along here this morning is that there's so many places now set up to eat, for beach chairs and all of that. I think in some way the government needs to start putting some controls in place, or the NCC, because it does take away a little bit from the beach. I know we want everyone to come and enjoy and relax, but sometimes too much can also deter. So, so we are gonna go up this way because what I wanted to share today was a section of Bridgetown, which is now part of the UNESCO Heritage Site of Bridgetown since 2011, that was one time in the 1800s a major hub of health. And it's important, I always think so, it's very important to take care of our health and well-being. So that's the part of history I'm going to share with you this morning. It's going to be short and sweet. It's not going to be long because this is our second anniversary. And we really want to spend more time enjoying each other. And also, from the group that's walking with me this morning, hearing their perspective on the EMC over the last 2 years. We also would appreciate to share your comments of how the EMC has meant to you. So, morning. Hi, how are you doing? Happy New Year. Yes. Please give my regards to mom and dad.
No problem.
Okay. And yes, wherever I go, I meet somebody that I know or somebody. I went to school with my children. So, yes. So, yes. This area. One time, this car park was really the major car park for this beach area here, actually. You could come here any day and park and go to the beach. But now it's all sectioned off and a lot of it is still, a lot of it is sectioned off and yeah, parking is for Copacabana and different areas. But one time, this car park at this time in the morning would have been chock block of people. So, as usual, I think I've lost everybody. Oh, they're coming sweetly and slowly and surely. So, I am taking to you to a corner of the outskirts of Bridgetown, what we call Gemma's Lane and Bay Street Lights. And this whole area is filled with nothing but history. Nothing but history. And this is where our health services started. Still one of the busiest in the area. This junction is no fun during the week. From Monday to Friday, it's chalk block. If something is happening in Bridgetown or by Copacabana or up Bay Street, this junction is just terrifying. You just kind of avoid this junction. But this set of buildings here in front of us is the old Barbados General Hospital. I'm going to show and pan you. Sadly, it got burnt somewhere in 2018. Yeah, it was part of a fire, but this is where the Barbados General Hospital started in 1844. And this was just after emancipation, because now what had happened is that the plantocracy was no longer responsible for the slaves on the plantation and their health. And there had to be a way for those persons now to get health care. And so this was built in 1844 to assist the poor with health care. And everything happened here, from surgeries to birthing babies to the whole nine yards. And this was in operation for 66 years. And then I believe the Ministry of Education took over, and then the Ministry of Health. To me, these buildings are so beautiful that they should have been restored and this be used as a health and wellness center. There could be people in here doing massages and pedicures, manicures, Reiki, small dress shops, doctor's offices, other offices, because the compound lends itself to that. The parking would be ample, and it would be a beautiful way to keep these buildings restored, because all of this is part of the UNESCO Heritage Site. So it really would be wonderful, especially that compound, to give it a different feel in this time and make it more relevant. A beautiful piece of property. And it just takes a little time. The government could start with one building and slowly, slowly get it done. Right here in the corner, there's a building called the Barbados Family Planning. And that was set up for two reasons: to allow free pap smears and breast checks and all of that. And because it is what happens in a town and part of the culture of the town, is that the red light district is just behind. And so in order to keep those ladies in good health, the Barbados Family Planning kind of opened its doors here in the 19. It was, yeah, they were open about 1970s. And the door, as you can see with the beautiful hood over it, that door was designed that way. It was designed that way as the entrance, so that to make it welcoming and so that people would just walk in. So the Barbados Family Planning started as a walk-in free clinic, mainly for women And then eventually they would include men and prostitutes and all of that. And I believe they may have a new home. I don't think that this is their existing home. But, you know, because the area behind them, which is Bay Street, which falls into Nelson Street, the activity was a different type of activity. It meant healthcare for all. And the brown and cream building that you can see with the beautiful jealousy, the beautiful balcony, that was the Bel Air Jazz Club. And a lot of renowned jazz artists throughout the world would have over the years played there before it eventually closed. But Bay Street was more of a little jazz area with three or four places, and it was really a hub. And then I panned to this building right behind me, which is the Old Eye Hospital. That's what we all call it. But this originally was built to house the British Army in the 1800s, and they were here up to 1906 in this building. And then this building was taken over and became part of the General Hospital. And then after that, it became the Eye Hospital. And then after that, it became the Welfare Department. So this was the last home of the Welfare Department. And again, the beauty of these buildings, the structure of these buildings, are such that they should be restored and used for something, you know, and not left as eyesores. As you can see, the same Barbados National Trust that we spoke about last week, Sir Ronald Tree, once the building is part of a historical interest, that plaque is put on, and it means that it cannot be taken apart or pushed down. Sadly, sometimes they find ways to work around that and eventually push the building down. But, you know, the beauty of this building along with the old General Hospital should be restored. And what's interesting about this entire area is that we have the General Hospital, we have the Eye Hospital, we have the Barbados Family Planet Clinic, and here is where the Catholics set up home with St. Patrick's Roman Catholic Church. And they built the church 4 years after the hospital was built. And the original church was burnt down by the Protestants of the day, because, of course, we are under the British Empire and the king is Protestant. So therefore, the Anglican church that we saw the last Saturday by St. James Parish Church is one of the first churches to settle. And therefore, they had the strength. So therefore, once they had the strength, I'll stop for 2 seconds so you can hear the bells of St. Patrick. So even that particular tune we all know from England. You also know it's 7 o'clock here in the morning. But so St. Patrick Roman Catholic Church built here, and then Protestants didn't like the idea of Catholics coming in and trying to take over their turf, you imagine? So what happened? The original church was burnt down, and then they rebuilt in 1899, and this location has been here ever since. Now the beauty of St. Patrick's Roman Catholic, they also have a beautiful garden of remembrance for persons who had passed, and you can go there and sit and all that, and the history. If you ever get an opportunity, if this church is open and you're here, walk in and you will see the beauty of the stained glass windows, the architecture, the limestone, the beauty. But here we are in a quadrangle of health. Persons taking care of your religious and spiritual being, persons taking care of your general health, your eye health, your body health. And it really would be wonderful if all this was restored. And it is every time that we are thinking of how life evolves, what then happens is then there are other ways. So when Nicholas got his calling to come and do these blogs, it was now our mental health, because we were all locked away. We all cannot communicate, and we had to find a different way to communicate. And he got the calling. Some of us don't listen to those calls. But I'm grateful to Nicholas that he heard his call and he came and continued to do the work that he does every day, coming out, you know, entertaining us, making fun, bringing friendships along, because all of that has helped us heal. So kudos to the architects of this area, of people who, you know, started in simple ways, just taking care of persons' health, body health, so that they can live beyond the age of 36 or 37. We think that's impossible to think of, but health conditions were so poor and so, you know, restrictive, and medicine wasn't where it is now, that you could not envision that somebody could not live beyond 36 or 40. That was considered old age. Now we have people who reach 110 and are in excellent health. So it really would be wonderful if they could restore these and, you know, move us forward. So today, that's my small bit of history.
Awesome.
Of that area.
Oh, I'm so glad you stopped there, because people said they want to see more of me. Yes. So as you can see, Marcia Padmore, thank you so much. There are two of me today.
Oh my gosh.
Awesome. No mirrors needed, as you can see. Ooh. Beautiful. Absolutely awesome.
Oh my gosh. So he has his shirt. He could not be outdone by us, right? So he has to have his shirt. And so St. Patrick's Woman Catholic Church also extended and have a school. And that was one of the early features of every church. There was a school next to it. So St. Patrick's could have a church, a school next to it. And I believe also they do a lot of work for the welfare and homeless society. They have mourning. They have things like where they will have clothes sales and rummage sales and things like that, and therefore to assist those less fortunate. Bay Street is still a beautiful, narrow little street. And this is one of the reasons that UNESCO has given us World Heritage Site accreditation in 2011. And that's because everything around here, Barbados's footprint from where we've been in Bridgetown, where we started on the bridge a couple of weeks ago, all the way up to the historic garrison, that footprint of roads and infrastructure really has not changed, and it has remained the same layout from the 1700s into the 18s into the 1900s. So this is what gave us the access to be a World Heritage Site. Now what is required is that buildings along the way that are historically with heritage and knowledge and significance to the area need to be restored, so that we retain and keep that World Heritage Site. This section that we're going to come up to is like party central. We're heading closer to Harbor Lights. And Harbor Lights, over the years, have produced the Blue Boxcar Band. If you've seen that, Blue Boxcar Band are only for those who are strongly inclined to handle alcohol for a long, long period. I remember that when they first started, they were literally just a blue boxcar, full stop, and a whole bunch of drinks inside the blue boxcar with tons of coolers. Oh dear. I think somebody's alarm just went off in the area. I hope it was not my voice. Maybe it was Nick's. So, as I was saying, Blue Boxcar Band started with just a blue boxcar. And you know, the old fashioned, you get some pieces of wood and put together and get some stoppers or whatever you can find and make wheels. It was literally that, a blue boxcar, painted blue, full with ice and full with coolers and ice and nothing but drinks. But thank God they have evolved and they're into costumes and all of that. And at one stage they were so rowdy that the National Cultural Foundation thought it was best to let them go down first and get them out of the way, so that they could, so that all the other revelers could come. Of course, Bajans being Bajans, we had to go on the call-in programs and call and complain and whatever. And now what you see is that what Holy always starts the band, and then the blue boxcar band. But it's what it is. It's our Barbadian culture. So We're coming up here to St. Paul's Anglican Church, and this has been established in 1833. It's amazing that on Bay Street starts from where we were the other morning by the Empire, and at that corner is the Methodist Church, Bethel Methodist Church, and then you come up and you get the Roman Catholic Church, and then you come up and you have the Anglican Church. And St. Paul's has been established since 1833. It's still a very vibrant Anglican church. The current rector is Reverend Irma Ambrose, and I find that she is innovative. She has created flea markets. They have a beautiful center for having weddings and functions and things like that. And they were one of two churches that had a full system of one cannot figure. Today is supposed to be a national holiday, and Bay Street is still as busy as ever. So that tells you. But St. Paul's had two churches when we shut down during COVID that could stream. The other one was St. Thomas Parish Church, and that's how the diocese was able to communicate with the Anglicans, because sadly we were all a bit behind. The Anglicans were a bit behind in having the system set up. We come to the beautiful Bay Mansion, and I watched, if you ever get a chance, I think they're also on YouTube, My Community, done by Sherwin McCaskey. It comes out on Sunday evenings, 7:30 after the news, and then it's repeated on Wednesdays at 1 o'clock on CBC, our national TV station. And in this area, they talked about Bayside Mansion being somewhere where they would produce something called EC bleach. And this has also been used as, it was a doctor's residence at one stage. But this, and I believe, because based on the architecture in the middle, if you can see the square with the blocks and all that, it meant that it had some British military history as well, because that is significant to when you look at the buildings around the garrison Savannah. They have a similar architecture. So I believe that this may have been one of the homes of one of the generals or admirals or those who were staying there. And then this building has evolved and evolved. But it's wonderful to see how they have tried to continue to maintain its original architecture and use it. I believe right now it may be a home, an elderly home, and you know, it does not carry too many people, but just enough. So this empty lot right here is the beginnings of a company called the Barbados Ice Company Limited, what we now know as Byco. Byco started here. And Byco was just primarily in those days for getting ice, because a lot of people did not have fridges. Imagine that, something that we take, you know, nowadays if you send up home, if you don't have a fridge, stove, washing machine and a microwave and a bed, you feel like you're in duck's guts. But there were tons of homes that did not have a fridge. And so, especially in this area and environs, and that's what they call themselves, the Barbados Ice Company Limited. Simple, and then it became the acronym BICO. Would provide ice. And so people would, you know, have small little chests, and they would just get enough ice for the day and then come back. And so this was a thriving business here. And then they eventually got into ice cream and all the other products that they make. And then they moved to the Harbor Road where they are today. And then this whole lot was really parking for Harbor Lights. So I passed Harbor Lights. All my fun talking about the church. I passed Harbor Lights. Harbor Lights is bad. Harbor Lights is fun. Tons of fun. If you're here, morning, Vicky. Morning, Claire. If you get here, that's the other thing about Barbados. See, everybody you see, you know. And I've lived here long enough that people know me as Nick. So yeah, Harbor Lights is a good party lime, a good party place. And in my teenage years, I had some real good fun at Harbor Lights. Tons of fun. And as we make our way back up to the car park and Browns Beach and back to Browns Beach, I should also let you know that we're coming to an area where they had a natural spring that used to come. The waterway is still here and it's set up that way so that because when water is accustomed coming one location for hundreds of years, it can't change locations. Even though I always remember Carl Williams' slogan, "We move the earth to please." Although he may move the earth to please, water is accustomed going one way, it will continue to go one way. So this is part of the water course for water that would come down through the hills of St. George and St. Joseph and come straight down here and pass and go right down through here. And Brown's Beach got its name because the water was always brown. Simple and easy. Nothing technical, but this was the waterway. So the waterway would come right down through here and there was a natural spring that would come right around here, come right through here and come right into this. And this is how Brown's Beach started. And that water used to be murky, murky brown, but now has beautifully cleared up. But that's how Brown's Beach got its name. And along here too, there are little bars and little dives and things like that, that, you know, Bay Street lights up at night. That's all I can say, it lights up at night. If I raise my hand a little bit, okay, I hope you have on your darker makers. You can see some scaffolding there. Behind there is Bayview Hospital, the old diagnostic clinic. And that was a relatively new hospital in the 60s and early 70s. Now it's under new management and being expanded. And it's one of the most beautiful vistas when you're staying in a hospital to look out and look out onto this beach and see all of this. So I'm gonna beg Nick's indulgence this morning and we're gonna take a little further walk and go up to the in front of the government building so I can stop so everybody can share their thoughts and their ideas. Let me just tell him that that's what I would like to do. Oh, Nicholas is still down the other end. Okay, he'll follow me. He'll follow me. So, Dimitri Ryan, I just going a little further up. Yeah, your legs down. So. I hope you've enjoyed our second anniversary walk. Tomorrow we will be, the celebration continues. It's a weekend of celebrations. We go to Crystal Waters, dear Lord. And we're hoping that Mr. Impact will provide a beautiful dance session for us. So if you are on the island and could not make our early morning walks, we understand. It's real commitment to get up and move at this time of morning, but you can come and join us at you can join us tomorrow at Crystal Waters and enjoy. So I just wanted you to get another quick glance of the government headquarters because it's so nice to you know, think of the government headquarters today, especially on this Independence Day, on this, not Independence, Errol Barrow Day. All of this, you know, has to be created by our leaders and their vision of Barbados and what, you know, Barbados to become. Yes, we're moving to republic status and that changes some of the dynamic, but should not change how we feel about our country and the contributions that everybody should make and be part of. I feel like I'm talking too much again, but I wanted you just to see this beauty. And again, this area used to stop short of where it is, and instead now it's more expanse. People can exercise, can walk, can be part of this whole area, and it is so beautiful because there are tons of people out this morning exercising, running, walking, and you know, and just generally enjoying the beauty of this. So I'm gonna take you back because I want the members who have walked with us this morning to share their thoughts of 2 years of being part of the EMC. I hope you also have your special memories. I think we have an EMC baby, and we have persons who have gotten engaged online. There are those of us who have lost family members along the way and feel the loss, but also feel the love. When there's birthdays, we celebrate it. Anniversaries, we celebrate it. When someone is sick, we're there to hug and give, you know, encouragement. And I think that is a beautiful thing. We must always remember to reach out to each other, love each other, care for each other, and just be there. Yes, Miss Kira is promoting nothing but love. And I know for me, I am grateful for this journey. I'm grateful for being part of this EMC family and all that it brings. So,
yes, sorry.
No problem. So those two young ladies I've known since I've been 7 that are running. So we're heading back to the beach. Everybody looks fairly relaxed. They look like they've enjoyed the walk. So have we enjoyed our walk this morning?
Yes.
I didn't talk too much.
No.
Okay. Oh, be polite. Yeah. Be polite. You see how well trained they are, that they're gonna tell me they mute me. You imagine how unkind is that? Yes.
Hi, stranger.
So, Nick, I am so hurt. They tell me that they're muting me.
They're muting you?
Yes.
Why would that be?
You know what I'm saying? Because I seem to talk too much.
No.
I can't figure
that
out.
That's impossible. I don't know how that happens either.
I don't know.
They do it to me every day though, so I understand the pain. I go home and cry all the time, every day after the vlog, and the insults are terrible. Have they insulted you?
No. No.
Nobody insults me, Scare.
Yes.
You can say whatever you want, right?
Yes, correct.
Okay, let's just say a battle with everybody here today. Let me see.
I just think that they're very well trained, but they know to walk behind me and correct.
I saw that as well too. And people muted their phones and stuff, so you have all the airplay.
Yes,
well,
I just think it's so beautiful.
Yeah. You're definitely without a doubt a serious teacher.
Oh yes, no, come on.
No, let me get the sun first, or we get blinded.
Okay. Is that bad? Okay. Hello. But you know, I was just here thinking I ain't getting enough camera time.
Oh yeah.
So we have to get a little bit of camera time.
Yeah. Anyhow, everybody, have a look at Nicole. No, look at me. Awesome.
We are having a grand time. And we are back where we started. I truly hope that I didn't talk y'all ears to death this morning. I find that once I get started, there's just no stopping. But just look how beautiful this beach is, and look how people are here exercising, doing paddle ball and all of that. I just saw my cousin and a good friend that, like I said, I've known them since 6 or 7. I think I've known Claire all my life. And Vicky's parents and my parents were dating in secondary school. That's how long those friendships go back. But so that's why Vicky shout out, hi Nick, because she knows me as Nick. She doesn't know me as Nicole.
I thought she was speaking to me.
No. But just look at all of this. And I'm going to stop for 2 seconds and try very hard, everybody, to give you a 360 of love in silence. Here goes.
You're silent now. Is this a circle of love by any chance, Nicole? Are you trying to be quiet?
I did it. Despite Nicholas trying to distract me, besides Jeanette and Mary running around the screen and trying to make me laugh, here I am, have my lips buttoned till I am biting into my lip, not to laugh out, to give you guys a 360 of love. So I'm going back to the group and let them give you their feeling of being here 2 years. So everybody, please share with those online this morning how it feels to be part of the second anniversary.
It feels wonderful. It feels great, and the historical view that you just gave really helps, you know, make it feel special. Even though we were lagging around, but it feels good and more people with us.
Yes. Ryan, how does it feel to be part of it? Because I know you watch online on mornings, but to be here for the second anniversary.
And for the first.
So I said, and the second.
And the first.
Uh-huh.
It feels beautiful. It's nice to have friends on the island.
Yes.
That I can come and talk to.
Yes. That's one of the most beautiful things about this, is that we have become a really wonderful and interesting family.
Absolutely.
So let's hear from these three.
Four.
Absolutely beautiful.
Okay.
It's very nice to be here again for another anniversary.
Yeah.
Hoping for many more. Mm-hmm. And everybody come on down.
Yes, come on down, yes.
Come on down, exactly.
Landshark, no words?
No, I don't have a got words.
He just bites.
And Miss Jay, where are you? Silence.
Mary.
She likes to have a thing. So Mary, tell us how you feel about this morning. How was it?
It's very, very nice. A whole set of new friends that I didn't know a year ago.
Yes.
So haven't met them, didn't know who they were, just saw names going by. And it's absolutely lovely to actually meet them and get to know each other. And we all seem to get along.
Yes.
Seemed to.
Yes. Carolyn, how is this morning? Carolyn's in my favorite dress, let me tell you. She and I are going to have a discussion about this dress. It's going to have to be a proxy. Please leave.
Being here is wonderful because when I do come back, you know, I have friends here, and to know that I can meet up with friends who have become, you know, very important to me.
Yes.
Very important part of my life, and I've grown to love this island. It's home.
Yeah. Yes, so I agree. I endorse that 100%. Last year when we were a little further up by Carlisle Bay, in front of Government House, in Government Headquarters, where we celebrated our first anniversary, I would not think that I would be holding the gimbal and talking.
Holding Nick's gimbal
and talking on the second anniversary. But that's the power of love. It takes us places that once we let go and let it happen, it's just totally amazing. So, I leave the last words to our fearless leader.
Negative. I'm just here to join you in last words. So,
yes.
We'd like to thank everyone for joining us this morning and for every day and for everything you do, because EMC is you all and it's us, it's we.
Yeah.
And we want to thank you for all your love and care and kindness and healing that you brought our way. We hope we've shared some with you as well, and we hope this is the beginning of a never-ending product of sharing love, kindness, and happiness, EMC, forever. We are looking at succession. As you can see, we have our historian on board now. We bring others on board bit by bit, because this is not me, this is us now. So have a happy day, and congratulations to each and every one of us. We love you all.
Thank you so much for being part of our second anniversary celebrations. Like I said, if you're here tomorrow on the island, please come to Crystal Waters. We would love to have you there. Have a drink, have a dance, have a hug. So. Bye-bye, everybody. Take care and tons of love.
Okay, I know I'm going to hug the camera for 1 second, but not for too long. Just to turn around and say bye to everyone. So here we go. Let's go.
Okay, everyone. Say goodbye.
Well-trained staff.
Well-trained people. Well-trained people. Okay, say bye to everyone.
Bye.
Okay, bye.
From sunny Barbados.
See y'all later.
Second anniversary, EMC Scott.
Have a good one.